Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review, and in this video I'm going to review Hermetamen by Grimm. Japanese musician Grimm has done numerous works on the industrial and power electronics label Steinklang Industries, and this is one of them. Grimm, aka Jun Konagaya, made two albums the previous year, one on Steinklang Industries and one on Tesco Organization, which both of them I thought were just okay and decent works. They were definitely not some of the greatest works he has done over the past couple of years. And as far as he has made stuff from like the 80s with the album Folk Music, then after this point there was a huge gap after he started making numerous releases on the 2010s and also having his solo name, where he would make more stuff based on just organ sound that give an archaic and medieval aesthetic to them, but also having some sounds that would give a traditional sort of feel from like Japan or something, but in general it would also have a post-industrial feel to some of those works. And this brand new album as Grimm feels like it goes more to this direction that he had as Jun Konagaya, so it doesn't really feel that much as a Grimm album. Even though he would have some of those tracks in some of his Grimm albums, it was definitely not the main focus, as his Grimm albums would go more into a death industrial and power electronic side, while also having some prime examples of power noise with really lo-fi production and some really raw and distorted sounds. And in general, this also doesn't feel that much as a brand new full-length album, but more of like a compilation or an archival, as these are works that he has done between the 1980s since the 2010s, so it's meant more to be like a compilation for those who are fans of the early Grimm stuff or the Jun Konagaya projects. But instead of like a compilation or an archival, it's just put into a full-length album. And I can get why these tracks were considered and were outtakes before, because they're not some of the greatest stuff, even in the realm of the organs and the synthesizers he uses as Jun Konagaya. Now, this quite short album containing only 8 songs has a pretty standard formula to it. You pretty much get those synth melodies that repeat themselves, and then there is always a background sound or a background noise throughout all of those tracks. For example, the first track, Wolf Organ, has some wolf howls in the background as the synth plays. On the other hand, Hamine has some bagpipe samples. That's also the case with the starting point of the track Chant a Spell. And there are other occasions with tracks like Check 9 Point or Dolpia where we have a more sort of field recording industrial soundscapes filled with quite raw and noisy textures just playing in the background as the synth accompanies it. In general, as far as this album feels like a compilation or a collection of tracks, they basically get so predictable and so just monotonous really fast. And I'm not that much of a fan of the way those two portions that are considered to be in any of those tracks just end up getting mixed together. This is a major thing with tracks like Check 9 Point, which is definitely one of my least favorite moments, just because the synth to it, the melody, is just so raw and it just feels like it's covered to the other sort of industrial soundscape accompanying it, to the point where the melody gets almost indecipherable and it ends up getting more lo-fi and more raw than what I would like to. In other occasions, you have tracks like Chant a Spell, for example, where towards the second half you get some of those sort of like chanting sounds and field recordings that feel like they come out of a ritual ambient track. But overall, there's not that much to comment about this album because it gets really repetitive and quite one-dimensional really fast. And some of the ideas over here, they don't feel like they're all that flattering with their production. As far as this album gets quickly one-dimensional though, in my opinion, it saves the best for last. Dolpa and Uterus are definitely my favorite moments over here, mainly because in their length they don't just put you straight into the mood with the synths. Instead, Dolpa makes almost 1 minute and a half till we get to this point, and for this 1 minute and a half it builds with those quite nice industrialized sounds that make for a nice aesthetic, and overall the sound and the melodies to this piece in particular feel like they're the most well developed, the most well focused. It definitely has the most distinct melody out of this entire project. And Uterus also gives a really nice touch with the sampling that goes to the background, and the synth choice and melody to this makes it one of the most compelling cuts out of this album. This album, yeah, it's mostly recommended for those who are fans of the early Grimm stuff and the Junko Nagaya stuff, but even if this is what you're looking for, in my opinion, most of the tracks over here do actually feel like outtakes, not enough highlights, in my opinion, in this album. It ends up being an underwhelming album with its quickly predictable structures, some poor mixing and production, an aesthetic that doesn't always work. And yeah, that's all I have to say. I'm going to give Hermit Amen a 6- out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it, dislike it, why, and what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.